Dun da da dun. Dun da da dun. Dun da dun. Dun da da dun. Sin.
Sin, what the? What are you doing?
I'm trying to practice, bro. I'm about to be a hero, bro.
About to be a hero? What are you talking about?
I'm about to do the, like, bro, I'm about to try to do the Invincible Hood review, bro. I'm trying to get into the mindset of being a hero.
Invincible? But what are you talking about? Sky High, the cartoon?
Bro, this joint is not Sky High, yo. Stop disrespecting me before, you feel me? I'll show you why they call me Invincible.
Said, listen, bro. In this case, you'd be Mark Grayson and I'd be Omni-Man. I'll really do you dirty with these. I'm not gonna lie. These hands are, you feel me, rated E for everyone, especially you. What you talking about?
Yo, Dweeb, yo, just put the beat on, yo, before I really drop you in here, bro. Like, hey, man, you know that it ain't a hood review without a rap, right? This is the hood review of Invincible, man. Hey, grab the strap. Man, you know it ain't a hood review without a rap. But I tell them, hey, I'm here to say today, I'm invincible with my pen, though. Back then, niggas played games and switched up like Nintendo. But that's cool, though, and extendo, a large clip. I'ma shoot them and it's all hips. Now we walk funny like a large bitch. Worry about like none of these niggas. Fake heroes and them fake villains. Headshot, not to hate out him. Dots on his head, he a fake Krillin. Rise to any height like I hate ceilings. Always high cause I hate feeling. Guilty dying to this left trigger. It's a southpaw like I'm Jake Gyllen. Going through it and I ain't healing. Heartbroken, but that's in the mission. Music firing, I'm independent. Hook dropping the bass there. And my lines carry like I'm inefficient. A lot of critiques, but they in the vision. A lot of lying and a couple bitches. But it never mattered cause a nigga killing. Hey, you know what the is going on, man? Hey, man, this is the hood review of Invincible, man. Oh my God, grab the strap. Grab the strap. Let's get it. Have you ever mixed like superhero story with like some real shit? Cause that is what this is. Oh my God, bro. I've been waiting so long to do this hood review. Bro, we are here today with the hood review of Invincible. And I ain't gonna lie, my editor's probably gonna do that cool thing where he like cuts out the Invincible. So like every time that I say Invincible, like you just see like the title screen. I hope he does that because that shit was kind of fire. I ain't gonna lie. But anyways, this shit is crazy. I remember when I first started watching Invincible, bro. It was an Amazon thing. I didn't even know it was a comic book at first. And until later on, and I did end up reading the comic. Oh, by the way, if y'all want me to do the comic hood review, because the comic is crazy. I ain't gonna lie, you gotta run up them likes. So I need at least 6,000 likes to do the hood review of the comic. Yo, at least 6,000. I'm gonna come all the way clean. But that's besides the point. This story starts off with Mark Grayson, a little, you know, suburban ass with a cool crew cut, you feel me? Now in the comic, he looked mad funny. The art gets better in the comic, but in this show, they did their thing. I'ma come all the way clean. Now Mark Grayson is the son of one of the most black Air Force personified I have ever seen in my goddamn life. The likes of Omni-Man. And we're gonna talk about Omni-Man at some point in this video, but first, we gotta get the prerequisites out the way, man. So this little Mark Grayson is the son of the world's strongest hero. At least the strongest hero that we know of so far. And this doesn't have powers. Now, the story starts off with like this rip-off-ass Justice League. Now, first of all, these are mad funny. And I don't mean funny like, oh, haha, they're comedians. No, I mean these look mad funny compared to like their counterparts for the Justice League. Let's run through these real quick. Now there's the new Guardians of the Globe, which them, we're talking about the former Guardians of the Globe, man. And they former for a reason, because I ain't gonna lie, them R.I.P. R.I.P. done killed the club. These is out of here, you feel me? But that's neither near or there. Now we got the team of Darkwing, which is just a fake ass Batman. We got War Woman, who is a fake ass Wonder Woman. Red Rush. Come on, bro. Red Rush. That shit sounds like a soda. Anyways, that's supposed to be the Flash. We got Aquarius or Aquarius. I think it's Aquarius. I don't fucking know. Aquarius, Aquarius, whatever. He's Aquaman. We got Martian Man. Are you kidding me? Which is just the Martian Manhunter. And then we have Green Ghost. Green Ghost, my like, I ain't gonna lie. Like, who you gonna call? Ghostbuster. Green Ghost. All right, anyways, that's a fake Green Lantern. We also have Black Samson, but like, you see him a little bit later. I don't even know what Black Samson's based on. Is Black Samson supposed to be Cyborg, I think, maybe? Cyborg? And then we have the Immortal, which, like, I don't even know who the Immortal is. And then Omni-Man is Superman, clearly. Like, who the f*** is the Immortal supposed to be based on? I don't even know, bro. Is the Immortal Super... No, that's... No, because that's clearly Omni-Man. Who the f*** is the Immortal? Like, that doesn't even make sense. But anyways, it doesn't even matter, yo. We gotta run through these shit. So, first and foremost, yo, we have f***ing Red Rush, bro. This Red Rush, I ain't gonna lie. I gotta talk about Red Rush here real... at some point when we get to that point after the first episode. But I gotta break down these though, because they look mad funny, bro. Red Rush is dead ass. Like, bro, if you don't get this fucking soda name the fuck out of here, bro. Bro, we got Mountain Dew, Code Red, Mountain Dew, Red Rush, bro. You sound like a Mountain Dew beverage, bro. Like, I'm gonna come all the way clean. And then you got this stupid ass fit on. Bro, I thought this was Daredevil at first. This is not dressed like the Flash, bro. This is not Barry Allen. This is not Wally West. This is, what's Daredevil's real name? It don't even matter. That looked like Daredevil, bro. He had this spandex on, bro. All I was looking for was a walking stick at some point. Like, my, you about to pull out the walking stick? You about to start smacking people with it? Like, what are we talking about? Green Ghost is just what a fucking character on a video game looks like before they have anything. You know, like, the very basis of a character, that green body? This is that. They should call it Green Screen Man. Like, bro, this is literally just a green with no type of facial features or details at all. What kind of stupid shit is that, bro? And then we got Darkwing, this fake-ass Batman. And then Darkwing is black, bro. The whole thing of Batman is white privilege, bro. And the fucking Snyder cut, they said, Batman, what's your power? Said, I'm rich. Bro, oh my God. Literally, you should call that capitalism, man. That's what Batman is. They made black. You gonna spit on black people and make this fucking white privilege ass a black dude and call this Darkwing? Oh, now he Darkwing because he black. And then we got fucking War Woman, fake-ass Thor's wife. Like, bro, she don't even look, though. She do look like Wonder Woman a little bit, but like, bro, come on, son. Didn't anybody get sued for this? Did DC get any type of money from these? Then Aquarius, this is nothing like Aquaman, bro. This is a fucking fish, bro, literally. Like, bro, this has the body of a Phoebos, bro. This is a Magikarp in a suit, bro. I'm gonna come all the way clean. Like, what the fuck is this? And then he's got these stupid ass fins. It's supposed to be like a mohawk, but it's fins. Like, bro, this is nasty, son. Like, this, like the mascot for Gordon's Fisherman is Long John Silver's ass. And f***ing Martian Man, are you kidding me? This looks like him. E.T. phone home. Like, this like he should be on signs. Like, bro, where the f*** they find this at, bro? And then Immortal, this look like f***ing Hugh Jackman. Fake-ass Hugh Jackman. This dumb-ass suit on, like, bro, oh my God, I f***ing hate these. And Omni-Man look like Stepdad Man. This has the gray sides with the fucking state trooper mustache. Like, what are we talking about? Big O on your fucking chest. What's the O stand for? Fucking old? Like, goddamn old as shit. Like, this is not Clark Kent. Like, what is this? This is Clark Bent. This is, what the fuck? This old ass, bro, this, like, he just wakes up every day, his back hurts, he reads the newspaper, he grumbles at the kitchen table, and then he goes, works his 9-to-5 at a desk. That's what fucking, this like, bro. This Viltrumite and shit, these live like hundreds of years. No shit, you look old as fuck. Like, I should be playing on fucking Seinfeld. This shit is ridiculous, bro. Get this on late night television show, bro. That's what this looks like, bro. But that's neither near or there, yo. Sorry I had to really rant on these fucking fake ass Justice League members, but god damn, son. Anyways, Mark Grayson is always stressed out about not having powers and shit. But I'm gonna be honest, I won't want anything to do with Viltrum or anything to do with Viltrumites in general. These are not shit. They are fucking planet conquering. That's what they do. So this dad, Omni-Man, you feel me? He literally is here to conquer this planet. He came here from Viltrum. They got this whole like, and oh, by the way, before I even go any further, I should say this now. This is spoilers. If you have not seen the first season of Invincible, bro, get the fuck out of here, bro, because I'm spoiling the whole series, bro. Like, I'm going to spoil this, bro. I'm going to keep it all the way 100 with you. So if you haven't seen Invincible, get the fuck out of here, bro. I'm going to give you all a second. Oh, yeah, editor, put a timestamp up for these. You feel me? Because this next part is super duper spoily. But anyways, so yeah, so these are from Viltrum, bro. And Viltrum is a dying planet. At some point, I'm not going to tell you what happened. Something happened to these and they had to like start spreading out and trying to conquer other planets, right? They take over planets. They make them a part of their system. They assimilate them in. And they basically, this is what white people do to every other race. You know, they make them a part of, you know, their culture, their race. They, you know, they put their own capitalistic ways over them. And then they're like, oh, we're going to make your life better. But you also have to do everything that we want you to do and be like our slaves. And that's kind of what these do. You feel me? It is what it is. Glorified slavery. So they take over planets, but they send just one Viltrum per planet because he's so powerful that once they like pretty much meet a mate that's on this planet, they have they own like Viltrumite child. They raise it up to be as strong as them. Two Viltrums can take over a planet of regular garbage. And what are they going to do to him? Nothing. We'll see that later. But anyways, he comes here. He meets you, Mark Grayson's mom. They get the, you feel me? Knocking f***ing boots, and my Mark Grayson is born, you feel me? And now this nigga is stressed out because he don't have his powers. Little does he know, he probably didn't want these motherfucking powers, because with great power comes great responsibility. And a bad haircut, what did your barber do to your hair? But that's neither near or there. At this point though, this Mark is at work one day. He's pissed off, his boss is tweaking. You take that trash out, Mark. So he goes to take the trash out. He's mad as shit, he throws it to, like, you know, do a little alley-oop, like, little, not an alley-oop, like a, he gets to just throw in a trash f***ing bag in the trash can, you feel me? But his powers kick in, and the f***ing trash bag flies to another country and smacks the trash everywhere on the and I'm like, oh shit, this got his powers, you feel me? So he goes home and tells his dad, and his dad is immediately intrigued, because at this point, his dad is like, oh shit, it's time to start trying to take over this planet. My son has his powers. So he gets to start training his son. Tries to teach Mark how to fly, how to control his super strength. And Mark does his thing. But it's like one of those situations where it's like, you got all these new powers out of nowhere. It's going to take you a little bit to learn. It's like, if Superman, you feel me, out of nowhere was like, oh, I'm super strong and I can fly now. And not just going to know how to do everything on his own. So, you know, he had to like do things on his, you feel me, with his dad trying to learn, get his shit up, you feel me? So we got old stepdad ass, you feel me, trying to teach him how to do things. But Mark is a hard-headed, so he starts getting into some trouble because he's like, I want to be a superhero now. I want to be out here and take over, you know, in my dad's job. And I want to help people out with no experience, bro. Like, God damn, shit is kind of crazy. So he ends up trying to do things on his own. He ends up meeting Adam Eve. Now, Adam Eve is a part of this little, like, subsidiary hero group. And they got some people in there that we gonna talk about. Oh my God, bro. Cause some, yo, it's so much funny shit that happened in Invincible, bro. Like I'm gonna come all the way clean, yo. So we got Robot, who, oh my God, some wild shit happens with this later, bro. Oh my goodness. We got Duplicate, like Duplicate, but Duplicate, like, hey, Kate, you feel me? Little Asian bitch, she can like duplicate herself. We got Rexplode, who's a bum, but ends up becoming a, you know, super goat in the comics. Sorry that y'all don't get to see him be a goat if you haven't read the comics, but that ends up being a goat. Like, I'm gonna come all the way clean. And then we got Adam Eve, you feel me? So she introduces, you know, Mark to all these niggas. So Rex ends up cheating with Duplicate, bro. This nigga, yo, Adam comes back to the crib, right? This nigga in like the sauna bath, and Duplicate is making like mad cakes, and he's having an orgy with these bitches in a sauna. This nigga is different. The nigga Rexplode kind of a goat. He's a cheating ass, but he's a goat though. Like, I'm gonna come all the way clean. This nigga is having an orgy with a bitch that can duplicate herself. Like, this is different, son. This is in that bathroom getting it. He with mad Kate's, you feel me? You remember John and Kate plus eight? Remember Kate had like eight kids and shit? It's like John and Kate plus eight, but it was Rex and Kate plus eight. More Kate's, you feel me? They was in there going crazy, you feel me? He was Gazer, and you feel me? Shit, I'm a woman out of, you know, but then he was going crazy. And that bitch, you feel me? She walks in, she catches him, she gets mad and breaks up with him. And I don't blame her, you feel me? Like, it kind of is what it is. Now, at some point, this teen team that they have or whatever kind of breaks up because of the friction between Rex and her and all this shit. Also, you know, at this point, this is after the first episode. At the end of the first episode, and now, editor, please cue the menacing music, because we have to talk about this Omni-Man. There's going to be two times where we cue menacing music for this. This guy Omni-Man kills his entire team. This Omni-Man fights the entire fake-ass Justice League, the Guardians of the Globe. He beats the shit out of him. In the comic, he negatives him. I'm gonna be honest, they didn't even touch him in the comic. But in this show, they start fighting back a little bit. He destroys these niggas, bro. The only that was doing anything was my nigga, Red Rush. And that's why I said Red Rush is a real, because he was really giving, he was zip, 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 zip. And I feel like that's what kind of would have happened with Superman too. Like, Flash would have kind of gave him some work, but it's Superman at the end of the day. So Omni-Man rips his apart. Yo, he's making his brains come out. They eyes is falling out the sockets. He's punching through them. Like, bro, this is destroying his whole team. Punishes these, and he takes Immortal's head off. Now, Immortal can't die, and we'll see later, but like, once Immortal's head is attached to his body again, he'll come back to life. So he knows that he cuts this nigga's head. Head gone, son. He punishes the entire team. You feel me? Then he gets the out of Dodge. And he does that because he knows that the Guardians of the Globe will be the only people that could really put up a fight against him and his son. I get it. He was taking out the threat. So because of that, the team splits up. And this nigga Cecil, who is working for like the government and also kind of like employs these superheroes. This fucking weird nigga, bro. I hate Cecil, son. Jesus. Before we even go any further, Cecil, please Bring your fucking liver spot ass to the front. Please, we don't get your fucking everybody loves Raymond face ass. Frazier face ass nasty ass. Boy, if you don't get your motherfucking nasty Homer Simpson head having that, you bought it on the side, your shit look like Saturn, like a ring around your head with an empty spot, shiny head ass. Boy, if you don't get your motherfucking pale milk dud head the fuck out of here, bro. Somebody took major pain and spray painted them white, it look like you. See, so you're ugly as shit, boy. You got this fake men in black ass suit on. If you don't get your motherfucking pallbearer suit the fuck out of here, fuck going on. Do you work for the government or a funeral home? Are you about to drive a hearse or you gonna employ superhero ugly ass? I hate this Cecil, bro. Big shoes, shiny shoes. I was like, nah, let me stop playing. But nah, this Cecil, he a bitch ass. He do some bitch ass shit, but it's for the greater good. You feel me? He do what he gotta do for the world. You feel me? And I respect him for that. He just corny. Like, it is what it is. But that's neither here nor there. So Cecil knows the entire time that this Omni-Man has killed all these people, but he doesn't bring it up or do anything about it because the Omni-Man is built fucking different. So he pretty much is just like, fuck it, we gotta take this L. And he puts the Guardians of the Globe team together. Now, at this point, we meet some new niggas. Black Samson comes back. He gets his powers back. We meet this little Frankenstein ass bitch, this little stupid ass bitch that Robot has a crush on. Now, Monster Girl, Monster Girl just is what it is, you feel me? But this shit is so weird what this robot does, and we gotta talk about it real quick. And I know I'm jumping all over the place, but it's a lot of shit we gotta talk about. Yo, Robot Girl, what the fuck am I talking about? Robot and Monster Girl's relationship is OD weird. So Monster Girl basically was a grown woman. She ends up getting this like curse spell put on her where like she could turn into a monster. But every time she turns into this monster, she gets younger, younger, and younger. Now she has the image of a little ass girl. This robot meets her, and because it's a cybernetic, at first it didn't bother me at all. But now when I found out what happened, somebody called the cops on this, bro. Please call the police on this. We got him. Like, somebody get this fuck, bro. This robot ends up being a grown ass, deformed, nasty ass man. That's why he got this suit and shit. This is living in a fucking tube. A fucking juice is keeping him alive, attached to tubes and shit, right? So then I'm like, okay, now it's kind of weird. You got a crush on somebody that looks like a low ass girl. But then it gets even weirder. This takes DNA from Rexplode, right? And I'm like, what is he doing with this? He clones a little fucking teenage version of Rexplode, and then he tries to get his brain and thoughts implanted into this little ass boy. And you're wondering why? Because he wants a body. He wants to be normal. No, because he wants to date a girl, a little ass girl. This wants to date a little ass girl, so he becomes a little ass boy. This robot is the weirdest in this show. Pedophile, whatever the you want to call this, bro. Somebody call Chris Hansen on this, please. Yo, somebody needs to hit this the antivirus program right now, bro. This doesn't make any sense, bro. This shit is crazy, son. Like, what the is going on? And I know we jumped all over the place, and I'm sorry, but bro, what the is that? Anyways, back to our regular schedule program. This Omni-Man, oh yeah, by the way, play the Medicine Music again. This Omni-Man is built entirely different, killed all his longtime friends. Yo, he is about his business, bro. These Viltrumite is not playing, bro. They are going to conquer whatever the fuck they want, and that's just is what it is, yo. That is their prerogative. That is their life. That is what they are going to fucking do, bro. This kills his whole team. Even the nasty fish, the bass mouth. That fish is now on somebody's wall. He's one of those talking fish, bro. You hit the button and they start singing, bro. That's what that is right now, bro. This is in Bass Pro Fishing Shop right now. Like, I'm gonna come all the way clean. But anyways, fuck Omni-Man, yo. Back to the story. So anyways, at this point, this Mark Grayson is running around with the teams, hit the Guardian of the Globe, as you feel me. They fighting aliens, they fighting all types of shit. Bro, one of the coldest moments though is they were fighting these aliens that keep coming back to Earth, and like then they realized that the Earth time frequency was different than theirs, so they started aging up. So they had to leave and create these little wristwatches. Then they found out about the wristwatches because Robot's a smart ass nigga, but he's also a weird ass nigga, you feel me? Sanji ass, you feel me? He tells them like, yo, let's break these shit. So they start breaking them, they start aging up. But Omni-Man shows up and he's like, yo, y'all can't come back here anymore. He says, this planet is not yours to conquer. That was our first red flag. What do you mean it's not their planet to conquer? What do you mean by that? This flies into the portal, follows them back to their home planet and their timeline. He fucking speed blitz their whole race. He kills everybody there. He blows up their whole planet, punishes these niggas, bro. He kills all of these niggas, doesn't have any bad feelings, doesn't have any type of bad conscience towards it at all, and then comes back like nothing fucking happened. This It's stepdad of the year. Like, please, somebody get this some Tom Ford. You feel me? Like, I'm gonna come all the way clean. But anyways, he punishes these fucking aliens, comes back like nothing happened. And I'm like, yeah, there's something off about this. I don't know what it is yet. Well, I do know, but at the time I didn't. But I was like, something's wrong with that, bro. I hit something off about him. So later on in the story, we meet one of the baddest niggas in this fucking story, bro. This is the time where we talk about Battle Beast. But before we get into that, we gotta talk about this machine head, son. This machine head is the funniest. Please, editor, put in some scenes of machine head, bro.
I said, shut the hell up. That ship has sailed, amigo. This is your life now. This is what you do.
This nigga talks with fucking auto-tune. This nigga would have made T-Pain so happy. He's talking to this nigga. It's a black dude that looked like Luke Cage. I forgot the fucking name. It don't really fucking matter. The editor probably put his name on the screen or some shit. But my point is, and fuck all that, is that this nigga talks with auto-tune. He's talking to the black dude. He's like, I know where your family lives. That's why you gotta work for me.
You think you can just punch your way out of this? I know where your family lives, and that means you work for me.
Like, this nigga is like talking with melodies, bro. This nigga's talking with harmony. Yo, him and Piano G would be the best friends ever, bro. Like, yo, this is killing it. Like, I'm gonna come all the way clean. But then we meet this nigga, Battle Beast, who, you feel me, Machine Head hires, and all the rest of these fucking villains that the Guardians of the Globe and Mark Grayson are fighting are fucking garbage. But Battle Beast is an entirely different. And I know we said we were gonna play the Menace in Music twice, but no, we're playing it three times, yo. Play the Menace in fucking Music, cause oh my fucking god, this nigga Battle Beast beats the fuck out of everybody in here, bro. I mean, 1, 2, 3, 4, fee, fi, fo, fum, they is on the floor. This is punishing, beating shit. Boom, boom, got a club. He got a big ass club too. He smacking with it. Boom, boom. This Mark Grayson run up, he get rocked. And when I tell you, he beat the fuck out of these, bro. He kills one. Well, at least at the time, I thought he killed it. But then he beats Mark Grayson so fucking bad, son. While Omni-Man is watching, and Omni-Man didn't do anything. And at the time, I thought it was because he was teaching Mark Grayson a lesson. He was like, oh, you want to do everything on your own, right? But then I realized when I read the comic that this Battle Beast is just really built different, and he would have beat the fuck out of Omni-Man. This Battle Beast is at a different level than this son. Yo, this Battle Beast beat Mark Grayson so bad that this had to change his name from Invincible to Vulnerable. This name was not the same no more. He beat the fuck out of this, bro. Like, bro, and I fuck with him because he's a cat. Let's talk about that. He's a lion, and I fuck with cats. Y'all know what the fuck it is. Stop playing with me. You won't call me a furry and all that. I don't care. That Battle Beast the cat. You feel me? I fuck with him. Wait, what the cat doing? You feel me? I want to pet him and all that. But anyways, that's neither near or there. He punished this, bro. Like, goddamn. So fast forward past all of this shit. Oh, my God. I almost forgot, but we got to talk about one thing in particular before we end the video with the Omni-Man discussion. Oh, my fucking God. We got to talk about Amber. Because I have a problem with you, Invincible. I'm about to go on an Amber rant. Oh, get ready. Strap in. Put the seatbelts on, guys. Because I'm really about to talk my shit. They did Amber so dirty in this show. In the comics, she does have no issues like this, bro. She doesn't really even have a character in the comics. She's just a regular ass, bro. I swear to fucking God. But they also changed her from being white in the comic to being black, and they made her a bitch. Why are y'all perpetuating black stereotypes? Why are y'all making the black girl have the attitude and be a fucking problem? Why didn't y'all keep her white at least? Bro, Amber is such a bitch in this fucking show, bro. And then there's this one fucking episode where they go to this college campus, right? Now, this Mark Grayson is keeping a secret, right? He doesn't want to know he's invincible, but his gay friend finds out that he's invincible, right? He's trying to, like, play it off, so he's like, yo, guys, stay here type shit. I'll be right back. I'm gonna go get help, get the police. He leaves, comes back as invincible, starts punishing. If it wasn't for him, you feel me? They would have died. Let's keep it 100. He saves their life, right? So fast forward, he's like, all right, I gotta tell Amber what's going on. He goes to tell Amber that he's invincible. This secret that is so big that could change his life for fucking ever. He barely knows this bitch. Doesn't even date her for nothing but a few months. And he decides to tell her because he likes her that much. Goes to tell her and she says, I already knew you were invincible. But she was fucking mad at him at the college. Talking about, oh, you abandoned us, when she knew the entire time that this was invincible. Amber, you're a fucking bitch. Like, everything about this bitch infuriates me. Like, bro, I swear to God, bro. The Chris Brown, the Mike Vick, the fucking John Jones would have came out of me. And I'm not glorifying domestic abuse at all. Don't hit women, but I would have slapped the fuck out of Amber in the show. Bro, you are literally the fucking worst. I hate everything about Amber in the show. I hate that it made her black and made her a bitch. Why did y'all do this? Fuck you, Amber. And you not that cold. You not even drippy like that. You look like you dressed from Baby Gap. Like, fuck is you talking about? Like, bitch, where you get your clothes from? City Tramp? Like, bitch, you not really like that. Like, bitch, you got dressed in a Walmart or something. Like, bro, like, what you talking about? You got these stupid ass clothes on. You not even fly like that. You got no body like that. Like, fuck you talking about? Like, yo, you talking to my man Mark? Like, he not invincible. Like, you a basic bitch. Fuck is you talking about? But anyways, that's neither near or there. Let me calm down. I gotta end this fucking hood review with what happened at the end of this fucking shit, bro. This Omni Man editor, cue the menacing music once again. Carcoons in the background too. Fuck you, bitch ass. Should fly out there with my superpowers and fuck you up and just drive your car into a building and hope your car explodes. But anyways, that's neither near or there. This Omni Man finally gets confronted by Cecil. They're trying to fight this nigga. Mark Grayson, his son, finds out that this nigga, what he's trying to do. And he's like, oh, no, I'm not with that. I'm not taking over the world. Fuck all that. I fuck with these niggas. So this Omni-Man proceeds to beat the living shit out of his fucking son. He's beating shit down his son's leg. Bro, y'all remember the fucking train scene? This nigga grabs his son's face and rams him through a train. Niggas are dying and he's getting guts, blood, intestines all over him. It looks like a meatpacking plant in this train. It looks like where Rocky Balboa was practicing with the meat. He was in a din-din-din, punching the meat. Din-din-din. Like, it's just hella meat flying everywhere. Pause. Bro, this shit is disgusting. It looked like they were packing sausages in here, bro. The shit is flying all over him, bro. He got blood over here, an eye over here, somebody's intestines there, a piece of a liver there. Like, bro, what the fuck, bro? It looked like a fucking Saw game that went wrong. It's disgusting. But he's beating the fuck out of this Mark, flying him through buildings, taking him to different places. It's Cyborg trying to stop Omni-Man. Don't work. Immortal came back. Didn't work. Bro, these is the new Guardians of the Globe trying. It don't work. It took for this Mark Grayson to tell his dad some real shit, though. This is where the infamous meme came from. He says, why do you know, care about these people so much? Bro, if you don't help me, I'm going to end up killing all these people anyway, so you might as well help. Let's make their life better. Think, Mark, think. And then this n***a's dad says, what would I have, Mark, if I don't do this? If I don't do my job, what am I going to have left? What am I going to have left in hundreds and hundreds of years when your mom dies, when all the people I care about die? And Mark says, you'd have me, Dad. And I ain't gonna lie, I teared up a little bit. I was like, that's some real shit. He said, yo, it don't even matter if everybody else died, because I live as long as you. We gonna be together. What you talking about? Like, it's me and you. That shit was crazy, yo. That shit, yo, because whole time he's beating the shit out of his son, like, bing bong, fuck your life. Like, he's punishing his. But he's like, Dad, even though after all this, after he tenderized this, like, you feel me, some fresh meat, pause, he still says, you would have had me, Dad. Me and you, nigga. Fuck is you talking about? And I'm like, yo, I really felt them on that. I was like, yo, that's some real shit. Yo, you can't even get mad at that. Then this, yo, Mark's dad, Omni-Man, starts, he's conflicted at this point. This don't know what's going on. This fly off and shit. And that's the last that we've seen of this, bro. And that's how the fucking season ended. But yo, Invincible, I'm telling you, the comic is crazy. Run up the fucking 6,000 likes if y'all want the comic hood review, because I know y'all want that shit. On God, on GD, on Folk, on Blood, on Crip, on all that shit, Latin King. What you talking about, nigga? On all that shit, nigga. BD, nigga. On all them, on Lamb Ramen, them, come on. On all that shit, nigga. I don't know what else y'all, on Pyru, nigga. Like, I'm representing all y'all, nigga. You feel me? Gang Equality on my channel. But for all y'all, nigga, I know y'all nigga, all wanna see that shit, nigga. And if you don't wanna see it, then you're a bitch. You smell like shit, nigga. You smell like cow manure, and you get no bitches, nigga. Bye!